everyone, Willow is here, and welcome back to the long, dark Timberwolf Mountain, where we have slept the night away. Well, we have 1 hour left of darkness. Let's just sleep a little bit more. But we need to go out and do some more exploring today, because I think that we have explored all there is to explore. I'm going to go ahead and add some sticks and maybe melt another liter of snow. But I want to go out there, and I know I wasn't going to open those cargo containers. I said I wouldn't open those cargo containers, but I'm just curious to see what's inside them. And I also feel like maybe we've, I'm gonna pull out some torches. And poster. And come on. Like maybe we've explored most of this area on this side of the map, so I'd like to see if there was like other directions that we could have gone. What's out in the other direction? So I don't know if there's anything out there, but we'll see. And what's our weight looking like now? Well, we can eat. Eat some more. Drink. All right. Our weight should go down the more that we consume of this stuff, but I might go ahead and drop a couple of those torches that we made. What's the weather like out here? It's not going to turn into a blizzard, is it? That would be bad. It's 1 degree out here. That's fine. I don't know. I'm torn. Do we go and open those containers, or do we go and explore some more? Maybe we'll just go explore. We don't really need anything in the containers, and I wanted to, I just wanted to open them up just to see what was inside of them, but I really feel like we just need to go and explore more of this map. We can always come back and open them another time, but, we'll see what is out there for us to find. I'd really like to see if there's a way that, you know, loops us back to the Mountaineer's hut to see how it all kind of comes together. That would be cool. That would be cool. It still looks very, very drab today. They're gonna look pretty dark in the video. YouTube keeps saying, would you like us to enhance the lighting? It's not the lighting in the video. It looks dark in the game too, so I guess some days are just darker than others. So. All right, hopefully we're not gonna be dropping down on top of a bear. Nope. We're overloaded. Okay. Before we do this, let's go ahead and drop We have 10 tinder plugs. Let's drop 5 of them. We have... Oh, that's right. We had all this accelerant. Let's drop that stuff. And the torches that we just made. Drop those. Okay. We can always make more torches. Okay. This is better. This is better. Here we go. We've been here! We've been here! Look! Look! We've been here! So now I know where we're at. Okay. So I think there's another twisty, windy cave. Oh, but there was a... There is a rock somewhere. Up above it. That we could deploy a rope. Where was that at? Is that over here somewhere? Because there was no rope on it, but you could deploy a rope. And we have a rope. So we could deploy it if we chose to. What's over here? Let's get a flare out just in case. I don't really know what was on the other side of that cave, so it'd be nice to find out what's on the other side of that cave, but have we been over here before? Maybe it all just looks a little different from... Last time. Is any of this looking familiar to you guys? Is there a rope over here? Or is that... Oh, is that the cave? Oh, that's the cave. That's the cave. So the twisty, turny, windy... cave that we did not make it through because I'm an idiot. It's over here. But I wanted to figure out where, because there's a spot over here. And this area over here up top where you could deploy a rope. And I don't know... I didn't know where, where that was that you could deploy that rope from. I didn't know where that spot was. still don't know where that spot was. I'm sure it's one of the areas that we already explored. I just didn't see it. I wonder if that's like over by the waterfall. I bet that's it. I bet that's it. So, you guys, mental note, I think there's probably a spot over by the waterfall where you can deploy a rope. So, to make it easier to go back. But we've already explored that area, so I think we just need to go to that twisty, windy cave again that we did not explore, because that might lead to another area. But this area over here, I feel like we've pretty much explored. I believe. If not, I mean, you can let me know. But we're just gonna go ahead and explore the other side of wherever we come out in this cave. So and Sylvester, I know that is her name, because it looks like Agstar in the comments, but the AG is the periodic element for silver. So Sylvester has requested that I use my lantern in the cave because it's easier to see. And that is a good suggestion, because torches are actually not as efficient for exploring as lanterns. They don't put out as much light as the lanterns do. So we'll go ahead and use the lantern. And I use torches just because they're so easy to just pull them out of the fire, and the lantern fuel. We haven't really come across lantern fuel, have we? Or maybe we did and I just didn't realize in one of the containers. Maybe in the containers we did, but anyhow. Okay, twisty, windy cave, here we are. And, oh, look, someone left us a knife and a hatchet and all sorts of good stuff. That was very kind of whoever left that. Who was that? Who did that? Okay, so again, since the last time when we were in one of these caves, going right served our purpose very well. So I think this time we should probably do that again. And so, although I don't know, someone left this and they didn't make it out, so. We'll see. And is this just going to turn us back around into, yep. Back to where we came from? Yep. Okay, so that one, that way does not work. So the first right did not work. We'll try the other side. We'll go this way instead. And already, I mean, this one is leading up somewhere, so already it feels like it's probably the right way. Come on. Why are we stuck? There we go. Again, we are stuck. I know. Come on. You can do it. Do it. Ooh, choices. What's over here? Okay. What's this place? Oh, we already saw him. Yeah. So, let's see. Looks like it leads up somewhere. This is another one of these. Okay. Watch that first step. Again on the edge, making me nervous. Okay. So, yes, a lantern was a good suggestion. Okay. I mean, scary. Oh, I guess it's not that big of a drop. All right. Here we go. Oh, and look at that. There is a way out. So I wonder what's going to be out on this side. Here we go. Let's see. That's the engine. Is that? Is it another part of the engine? I wonder. Let's get our trusty flare out just in case. Because we saw one engine. Is this the other engine? New location discovered. Engine. So this is a new location then. Okay. Just want to take a peek over here and see. See if this is someplace familiar down here. And there's no rope on this, so we are carrying a rope. Let's go ahead and deploy it so we're not carrying that weight around. That will free us up a bit. Okay, but for now, let's explore. Let's see what this place has to offer us. Looks like a bunch of trees and snow and mountainous hills around it. So. much the same as the other areas, it would appear, but... It's nice how they have those trees pointing in the direction of the caves. There's a wolf over yonder. Oh, let's get out a torch, perhaps. Is that another one over there, or is that a deer? Ooh, we can use our fire striker now. I forgot we have a fire striker. The wind is picking up a little bit. So if they are patrolling around this area, is there something significant around here, I'm wondering? That's generally the way it works. Generally. What's down there? I don't know. I hear you, but where are you? Where are you? Oh, he's got a rabbit. Curious if there's anything up top here. Can I not go? I want to go. I want to go up to there. Nothing up here. Just a good vantage point, I guess. Alright. Well, let's head back down. Oh, there is a rope over here. Is there anything else? There's some sapling. There's sapling. And... anything else over here? Nothing over here? Curious about. I think that might lead down to the, maybe that leads down to the mountaineer's hut right there. Oh. Torch is gonna go out soon. So is there anything else of significance over here then? Well, what time is it? Let's see what time it is. 8 hours of daylight left. We're tired, we're hungry, we're thirsty, but we're doing fine. So our warmth, so... So this may end up being the last episode if we have, if we make it back to the Mountaineer's Head. I feel like we've pretty much explored, if not all the area, then at least most of the area, most of the significant spots. And that was really my goal for this series, was just to, just gonna be a little mini-series to, explore in this new area a little bit. It wasn't supposed to be, like, a comprehensive guide or anything. Just having a bit of fun. Seeing what this new area holds, but... I wonder if there's supposed to be, like, a... There's a lot of saplings in this area. That's good to know. But. And we're. Let's back to the engine over here. Maybe. Containers and more saplings over there. So, FYI, good spot for saplings. And, yep, the engine down there. Okay. So, now you know there's some, might as well just go over here and see what these, what's in this cargo container here. Looks like the torch is burning inside of it. Crackers.
Best be prepared for anything.
No, we're not gonna pick up any of this stuff, but just so you know, if you are a fan of energy bars and crackers. Good stuff. Oh, nice.
This stuff will come in handy.
Well, it really won't. I'm just putting it all back. But, okay, so... So I guess... that's good to know. That's good to know that this... If this place is indeed close to the... Mountaineer's Hut, like I think that it might be... Then that's good to know that there are some clothes nearby. To be had on your way up to the summit. So, making a mental note of that. For when I do this in stalker mode. Come on then. Come on then. Woo-hoo-hoo. Come with me, buddy. Come on. Come on. All right. Your shenanigans amuse me. You want a piece of this? Huh? 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. I don't know where he went. All right. Then let's just come over here. And perhaps climb down. I think this is where we climb down, right? Is this the spot or is it... Or is it around the corner here? Over here? Okay. So is this the top of the waterfall by the Mountaineer's Hut then? I see a wolf over there. Well, we've got a flare going, but I don't know if we can hold it and climb down the...
Damn! Oh!
Seriously? Can you climb down with a sprained ankle? Because I kind of want to make her try. Let's see. Can you climb with a torch? Nope. You can't. So, I'm going to go back up here. And I want to... Nope. I want to go around. Pick up my torch. Throw it down there. I'll see you in a minute. Here we go. Now we can go down. Hey, look, there's a torch. Or there's a flare. That's handy. Now, if this is by the Mountaineer's Hut, which I don't know if it is. I don't know if this is or not. But, if it is, then, there's a bear den around here somewhere. So, we need to be... a little bit cautious. And this wind is really strong too. Let's over here. More saplings. Lots of saplings. And there is a wolf over yonder. And down to our last flare. What is this place? What is this place? And we're exhausted. But I do believe if we continue going down here, and let's I'm not gonna stop here where there's a wolf. I'm just gonna stop and eat, but there's a wolf like not too far back from us, so. Continue on, because if this leads down to the mountaineer's hut, then we can duck in there. But, I'm not sure if it does or not, but I just know that. Yeah, there's the fishing hut, and it looks like, yeah, it looks to me like the area where, if this is Crystal Lake, then this is the Mountaineer's hut, so. There was, an area that we did not explore with the wing section, and some cargo containers down there. So if there's time left in this episode, we'll do that. But I think this is pretty much going to wrap it up for this series, though. Because there's the Mountaineer's hut, so. I feel like we've discovered the most significant places, and we kind of got a better general understanding of how everything is connected on this map. At least I think so. I hope you guys found it a little entertaining and maybe a little bit informative as well. So I'm sure there's still more places to discover, still more stuff to see, but and I would do that in this series, except that my son is now on Christmas vacation from school, so I don't really have the time to really fully explore this place in great detail. But this gives you at least I think a good overview of this new area. And like I said, I'll be doing another series, a stalker mode series. We have returned. Honey, we're home. Closing the door. We're back. We've made it. We've returned. Okay. But the episode is not over yet. We still have more we can do, so. Let's eat. Let's drink. Let's do this thing. And drink. We're exhausted, so let's sleep. Let's sleep. My goodness. We need some sleep. Let's put that away. What is the air temperature? It's 17 in here. Really gotta watch. I didn't realize when I slept in here the last time. You really gotta watch to make sure that you're not getting too cold, because this is not a like the cabins at Mystery Lake that will stay warm. 5 hours of daylight left, but we're just gonna go ahead and sleep for 4 hours and then make sure that the air temperature stays relatively decent. Sometime in the night we'll probably start a fire just in case, but since we aren't gonna be, we're not in danger of any predators attacking us in here. At least I don't think so. I don't think they come in this little hut. That would be bad news if they did. Alright. Let's see. 1 hour of daylight left, so let's sleep for 4 more hours. And then check our temperature then. It's like 11 degrees. That's pretty decent. Sleep 4 more hours, maybe. Those MREs sound very crunchy. I wonder what kind they are. 7 degrees. Might as well just use all of this, right? Let's just get a raging inferno going. For our last night. All right, let's see. I don't know how much time is left, but all right. 3 hours of darkness left. Let's sleep for 4. And then we'll go ahead and, unless there's a blizzard or something crazy, then we'll go take a look at that wing section. And I'm taking out that distress pistol, and I'm just shooting at everything that crosses our path today. I mean, we have this thing for a reason, right? Oh, but it looks a little bit stormy out, maybe. Oh well. Oh well. Let's take a look anyhow. Let's go explore anyhow. There's a wolf. Hey, wolf. I want to see how this thing works. He saw me coming. He saw this pistol coming. He's like, I am not messing with that. No, thank you. Hey, deer. Yeah. That deer knows, too. Oh, yeah, he does. Should I shoot him? I'm not gonna do that. Not gonna do that. I think the wing section is just right over on the other side of this hill over here. And it is guarded by a couple of wolves. I started a run in the pilgrim mode because I wanted to do kind of like a mini... sort of, not a tutorial, but just kind of like a walkthrough of like, this is how you go to get from Pleasant Valley to Timberwolf Mountain. So I did a little bit of exploring in that pilgrim mode. That was after I started this series, but I did a little bit of exploring then, and I found this section over here. See a wolf down there. I hear a wolf barking, chasing something. The deer. Oh, look. Two wolves going after that deer. We should shoot them both. Other deer's like, nope, nope, no thanks. I'm good, thanks. Oh, that was fun. That was fun. You want some more of this? You want some more of this? Yeah. That is fun! Where has this gun been all my life? Well, it's been up at the summit of the hill, I suppose, but, what is it chasing now? Chasing another deer? Yeah. Okay. I think we're just gonna have to drop this wolf. Nope. Might be too windy out for this, but we shall see. Otherwise, I think they're just gonna keep coming back. Well, I can't see you there. Okay. There we go. Thank you, sir. And a hacksaw. Well, that would have been good to know that this guy has a hacksaw. I am not taking your sardines, sir. Nope. Don't need it. Let's find out what's inside here. Peaches? Nope. This is gonna be the peaches and pork and beans cargo container. Nope. Nope. Mm-mm. Come on. What else do you have?
I'll take it.
Nope. 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 All right. And what do you have for us? No!
I think I can use this.
No, you cannot. I'm just putting everything back. But, good to know what's in these containers. Just in case. So it's not that this map doesn't have very much loot. This map has tons of loot. You just got to get to it. We'll take a flare. Sure, we'll take...
I don't know. Could end up being useful.
No. It's not going to be. We're not going to use our lantern anymore. But so you guys know, lots of good stuff. Was there any others, or is that... Any over here... Discovered the wing location. Just wanted to look around to see if there were any other cargo containers. Doesn't look like it. What's over here? What's over yonder? You know what, this is... What all do we have in here? Let's, Oh, it's... We're not very overloaded. It's just that, the wind is just blowing in our face. So that, I think that just circles around to the ravine, to the Echo Ravine. So, get our trusty distress pistol out. See if we can't find ourselves a bear. I want to see how this works on a bear. That's going to be the real test, isn't it? If it works on a bear. Here, Smokey. Over by the bear den now. Is there a bear in the bear den? Have to go hunting a bear. No bear in the den. Maybe back over by the lake. I know. There's a bear. Hi, bear. This may be the grand finale, depending on how well this works. Oh. Hey, bear. Hey, bear. Hi, bear. How's it going, bear? How you doing, bear? Hi. Hello. Oh, I need to load it. Hold on just a second, please. Thank you. So there you go. It scares the bear. Bye-bye, bear. All right. It works. We know it works. Well, that was pretty much all I wanted to do in this episode was to shoot this at a bear and to make sure that we had explored all the significant regions, and I wanted to see how they all kind of tied together and how they're all kind of interconnected. And you want some more, bear? You want some more of this? You didn't learn your lesson the first time, huh? I'll shoot you. That rabbit's like... Okay, that one did not work. Let's get inside here real quick and then... Whoop, reload. And come out here again. And where's the bear? There he is. Okay. All right. Well, this is it, guys. Just so you know, bear doesn't take too kindly to being shot with that thing multiple times. So. Oh, bear. Yeah, I know. This has been fun, though. This is good times. I know. I know. Here. Let's pull out the rifle then and shoot him in the butt. I was hoping he'd come back.
Pull through this time.
Finish the job. I know. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this series, this little mini series. I had a lot of fun making it, and this is the way I want to go out. Nope. Let's see. This is the way I want to go out.
Might be the end.
Oh, where's my distress pistol? Where's my distress pistol? Is it laying on the ground somewhere? I don't know. Anyhow, we're just shooting off our rounds here. And this is how it ends. Yeah. There's the bear. Oh. And let's fade into the long, dark. Died from blood loss. All right. Discovered 60 locations, explored 37% of the world. So, anyhow, I hope you guys had fun with this. I know I did. And I just kind of wanted to that was perfect timing. So, anyhow, just wanted to explore a little bit of this new region, just to kind of give us an overview of what this new place is like. So, and I hope you guys will tune in when I do the Stalker Mode series. It'll be a fun one. Anyhow, if you enjoyed this episode, hope you give it a like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next series. Bye-bye.